Good morning, this is Paul Gandharav. I am working as an assistant professor in St. Martin Engineering College. Now I have to give the small demo on polymers. So first of all, you have to know what is the meaning of polymers, how to define that one is polymers. The polymer is a combination of two Greek words. That one is poly means many and man means parts or units. That means how to define that one is polymer. The polymer is a large molecule of which is formed by the repeated linkage of small molecules called as a monomers. Examples, the small example that one is, we have to take the ethylene and that one is polymer. The polymer is nothing but polyethylene. In these examples, the ethylene is nothing but that one is monomers. That one is small unit. The small unit, that repeating unit is nothing but that one is monomers. That one is after number of monomers to combine to form a that one is large molecule. Large molecule is nothing but that one is polyethylene. Next, this is a polymers. We have to take number of monomers. That one number of monomers. In this number of monomers, that one is combined by which process? That one is polymerization process to form a that one is polymers. That means number of monomers to combine to form a that one is polymer. Okay, these are the examples. In our daily life, we have to polymer is applicable in different area, maybe domestic area, maybe industrial area, and commercial areas also we have to using that one is polymers. These are the example for the that one is polymers. Okay, next, polymers in daily life, that one is clothing, oil recovery and food and flavors and agriculture purpose also, and packing consumer items. That one is clothing, toys, skin care, automobile parts. Next one is industries. Industries means that one is making of the pipes related, maybe parts, additives, and many electronics is also applicable. That one is electronics and also medicines, and like a protein, antibiotic and coating for the tablets and gel caps. So the polymer in our daily life. Okay, next one, uses of polymers. These are the medical uses. That one is polymers. Heartworms, the plastic, that one is a small sensitive plastic appliance. That one is heartworms and blood vessels and syringical meshes and disposal syringes. You have to also use disposal syringes and drug containers and polyethylene used in the formation of food bag and carry bags. Polyethylene used in the formation of the water container. Polyvinyl chloride used in the coating materials. Okay, next one is polymers based on the natural process, based on the man-made. The polymers, mainly that one is polymer classified into two types. That one is natural polymers. The what is the natural polymer? The existing living things in nature by the formation of that one is by the natural process to form that one is small molecules to form a large molecules. That one is natural polymer. But synthetic polymer, the synthetic polymer is nothing but man-made in laboratory to the chemical process, by applying of chemical process. Under the involving that one is human beings, that one is the polymers is formed. The polymer is nothing but that one is synthetic polymers. Examples, what are the examples? That one is proteins, cellulose, wool, silk, starch, natural rubber, that one is DNA. These are the examples for the natural polymers. My synthetic polymers, synthetic ones, that one is plastic, synthetic fibers, synthetic rubbers. These are the examples for the that one is synthetic polymers. Okay, polymerization process. How to form that one is polymerization. The polymerization, the process by which monomer molecules are linked to form a large polymer molecule is called a that one is polymer. This is a process. In this process, that one is binding manners are single unit together through a variety of chemical reactions, maybe addition reaction, maybe condensation reactions, to form a large chain. That one is polymers. The process, the formation of that process is nothing but that one is polymerization. Okay, the important as a polymer, they exist with a monomer, which are small single molecules such as the hydrocarbons and amino acids. The hydrocarbon and amino acid to come that one is polyamide, and the number of hydrogen and carbon to form that one is maybe cellulose. That one is proteins. These are one of the process that one is polymerization process. Okay, and degree of polymerization. In this polymerization, the repeating unit In previously we have explained that one is ethylene molecules. Ethylene molecules to form that one is polyethylene. In this formation of polyethylene molecules, what are the repeating units? The repeating unit is nothing but that one is ethylene. Repeating unit is nothing but that one is ethylene. How many repeating units? So in we have to explain in degree of polymerization. How to degree of polymerization? Number of repeating units in the polymer chain formed is called a degree of polymerization. Okay. For example, we have to take polyethylene. C2H4, take closer bracket, that one is N. The N belongs to the that one is how many monomers are combined to form a that one is polyethylene. That one is in this chemical equation, in this monomers we have repeating unit, that one is ethylene molecule, that one is N belongs to that one is degree of polymerization. Even degree of polymerization mainly depends on that one is how to explain that one is hard and resistant, heat resistance and low density polymer, that one is soft and gum. The low density and high density polymers mainly depends on that one is degree of polymerization. Okay, next functionality. Functionality mainly depends on that one is maybe functional group, number of functional group present in that one is monomer, or maybe pi bonds, number of pi bonds present in monomers. That one is how to take that one is acetic acid. In this acetic acid, what is the functional group? That one is acetic acid, that one is acid group. In this, that one is alcohol group. Alcohol group, that one is 2 alcohol group. That one is the functional group, 2 alcohol group, the functionality is 2. In ethylene molecules. Ethylene molecules, how many that one is sigma pi bond, that one is 1 pi bond and another one is sigma bond. That one functionality, that one is 2. In that one is ethylene molecules, so 1 pi bond, that one is 2 pi bonds, 1 sigma bonds, and remaining that one is hydrogen bond. This is functionality, that one is 2. And another one, that one is replacement. The replacing of that one is any atoms, that one is also belongs to the, that one is functionality of the monomers. Okay, functionality of the monomers. Next, how to classify that one polymers? Mainly based on the origin of source. Next one, based on the structure, based on the molecular forces, based on mode of polymerizations. These are the based on this main property, we have to again that one is classified into that one is different types. In first one, that one is based on the origin of sources. Based on the origin of source, we have to classify that one is natural polymers. One is natural polymers, next one is synthetic polymers, semi-synthetic polymers. Next one, based on the structures. Based on the structure, that one is linear polymers. Second one, branched chain polymers. Third one, that one is cross-linked polymers. Next, based on the molecular forces. Based on the molecular forces, that one is elastomers, fibers, thermoplastic and thermosetting polymers. Next, based on the mode of polymerization, based on the process, formation of that one is molecules by the combining of number of molecules by the chemical mechanisms, that one is addition polymerization, that one is condensation polymerization. This is a classification of that one is polymers. Next, classification based on the that one is natural polymers. Natural, these are the existing living things in by the natural process. Example, cellulose, starch and rubbers. Semi-synthetic polymers. The semi-synthetic polymers is formed by the that one is synthetic origin. It is known as a semi-synthetic polymers. Next one, synthetic polymers. These are the polymers prepared by the laboratories. That one is man-made. Example, that one is Buna S rubber, Buna R rubber, nylon, polyethylene, polyesters. These are the examples for the synthetic polymers. Okay, next one is classification of based on the sources. Again, that one is classification of polymers, natural polymers and synthetic polymers. Okay. Types of plastic properties. That one is thermoplastic and thermosetting plastic. Based on the softness and hardness. Based on the softness and hardness, that one is classified into molecular forces. Based on the molecular forces and softness, that one hardness, that one is classified into two types: thermoplastic and thermosetting plastic. You have to see thermosetting plastic. This is a hard plastic. In computers, we have to use the keyboards. keyboards in two-wheeler, four-wheeler vehicles, we have to use that one is plastic, hard plastic. But soft plastic in domestic purpose, we have to use that one is maybe buckets and mugs, polythene carry bags. These are belongs to that one is thermosetting plastic. Okay, what is the difference between thermosetting plastic and thermoplastic? Thermosetting plastic cannot be bent easily. It may break when forced to be bent. Okay, thermoplastic can be bent easily. Why? Because this is a hard plastic, this is a soft plastic. That's why it easily that one is bent. Okay, but the thermoplastic is a hard plastic. It cannot be bent easily. Thermosetting plastic cannot be softened by heating. It cannot be reshaped once molded. It cannot be reshaped. Why? Because this is a, that one is a soft plastic. This is a hard plastic. Now, thermoplastic can be softened easily by heating. It can be reshaped. These are the difference between the thermoplastic and thermosetting. Okay, next one is addition polymerizations based on the chemical mechanisms, chemical reactions. That one is two types, addition polymerizations and container polymerizations. A monomer must have either a double bond or triple bond. In addition polymerizations, mainly consists of monomer. Monomer have that one maybe double bond and triple bond. But that one is container polymerizations. In container polymerizations, the monomer must have two similar or different functional group. Products. No byproducts are formed. This process, no byproducts are formed. That one is number of monomer. That one is repeating to form a large molecules. In this process, in this formation of large molecules, there is no formation of that one is byproducts. But in container polymerization, byproducts such as ammonia, waters, HCLs are produced. The addition polymerization is a process which is formed by the addition reactions. Addition reactions. When many monomers bind together with respect to the rearrangement of bond without loss of any atoms or molecules. And examples, we have to take that one is ethylene. Ethylene, the number of repeating units, this repeating unit to form a repeating unit nothing but that one is ethylene, to form a that one is polyethylene. Polymerization process, this is a process to formation of large molecules by the combination of that one is small molecules. Examples. Examples. What are the examples? That one is plastic, water bodies. Water bodies. This is soft. Some are soft plastic. Some are hard plastic. Some are soft plastic and hard plastic. How to form this one? Addition polymerization. Next one is container polymerizations. The container polymerizations. That one is examples. Dicarboxylic acids. Dicarboxylic acid. And that one is dialcohol. Two are combined. We have to eliminate that one is waters by the containment process to form a polyesters and give a byproduct that one is waters. Next one is dicarboxylic acid and diamine. Dicarboxylic acid and diamine in this monomers, that one is byproduct is that one is waters and main product that one is polyamine. Okay, next one is that one is polyesters. Polyesters, that one is applications in container polymerization. Container polymerization, and these are the amine group. Amine group, we have to form that one is parachutes, and the next one is tubes also. Hard tubes and soft tubes. Okay. Next one is nylon C6, how to make that one is nylon C6? It is also polymers. What are the monomers? The monomers are hexamethylene diamine. One is hexamethylene diamine, hexamethylene. Hexamethylene means that one is 6 methylene molecules and diamine, amine molecules and adipic acid in that four that one is ethylene group and remaining two acid group, that one is adipic acid, and two are combined by the elimination of that one is one of the byproducts, that one is water. And bond that one is to form a that one is amide. That one is right side is in 6 ethylene molecules and left side that one is 6 ethylene molecules and right side the 4 ethylene molecules. In between the middle formation of that one is amide. Okay, amide. Next one is that one is applications. applications, that one is a stitching thread, that one is that one is net manufacturing purpose, that one is you have to use, that one is nylon 6. Nylon 6 is it also, that one is nylon 6. Nylon 6 is that one is one of the applications, that one is containing polymerization. Next one is types of polymerizations. Types of polymerizations, additional polymerizations are other name, that one is chain growth polymerizations. Next one, coordination polymerizations, condensation are the step growth polymerizations. Next one is co-polymerizations. These are the four types. And additional polymerizations. Additional polymerizations, in this additional polymerizations, mainly involved in that one is four steps. That one is first three steps. First one is initiation process. Next one is propagation process. And the last one, that one is termination process. In addition, polymerization. We have to see, that one is initiation process. We have to take the one examples. We have to take that one is hydroxy group. Peroxy group. In peroxy group to form a, that one is radical. In presence of that one is ultraviolet radiations. This radical, the initiator is attached to the that one is one of the monomers, that one is ethylene. Again, these radicals and this is bond, pi bond is broken, that one is to form two radicals, left side and right side. The left side, that one is radicals, that one is react with the right side radicals to form a, that one is bond. And remaining, that one is right side, that one is one radical is vacant. One radical is one. Again, that propagation process, this radicalization of that one is monomer combined with another monomers to form a, this is a another monomers. Again, the process is repeating process. In each step, that one is formation of radical related that one is monomers. But termination, two radical related that one is monomers. The repeating unit to form a, that one is large size molecules, that one is in this last step, that one is ending step. Finally, we have to get the large size of, that one is molecules. This is the initiation process, the propagation process and the termination process. Okay, termination process. But common examples for the ancient polymerizations, that one is polyethylene. This is a monomer, that one is ethylene molecules, another one is polyethylene. Okay? Thank you.